AskReddit. Managers out there in Reddit land, what's your best? And so I had to fire the guy's story? Every manager has a good slash bad slash bizarre firing story. What's yours? We had a sales incentive my team hit their target for, so we all went to an island resort for a day, to hang out, play volleyball and ride quad bikes. At lunchtime, we put on a modest bar tab for our 50 odd team, around 2 beers each. People started buying their own beers and having a good time, without going over the top. One of the top sales guns, we'll call him Marky, is mingling with the team. 5 meters away from his boss, with hundreds of meters of beautiful deserted beaches in both directions, Marky pulls out the biggest blunt I've seen in my life, and has at it like it was the last one on earth. Really, his gusto was impressive. I gave him the, really? You're gonna do that right now, eyes, and so I had to fire the guy. The kicker is that he booked a room in the resort on the island for the night, and we were 5 minutes away from catching the ferry home. If he'd waited 10 minutes to blaze, it wouldn't have been on work time and he'd still have a job. I had this girl working for me as a lab technician. She was this little Chinese girl, 7 months pregnant, really nice. One day she comes up to my office crying. Her purse had been stolen from her locker. The lock had been cut. It contained her cell phone, car keys, green card, money, everything. Apparently it is very expensive to replace a lost green card. She said it was $400+. Also, since her car keys were now gone, she had no way to drive home. She lived 50 miles away. Keep in mind, 7 months pregnant. So her husband had to leave his job to bring her the spare keys, so she could drive her car home. Meanwhile, I review the security tapes with HR, and lo and behold, we caught a girl on camera with a ducking pair of bolt cutters going into the locker room. The girl we saw on the tape was one of the other lab technicians, my employee and someone the victim worked with every single day. We used the company bolt cutters to get into her locker, and we found the bolt cutters she had used. We also found food and a bunch of other shit she was not allowed to have in her locker. At that point we didn't need to prove the theft to fire her, but we were going to try anyway. The next day she comes in to get her check, and we bring her into HR and show her the bolt cutters. She admits that she took the purse, took the money and credit cards, and threw the rest in the trash. We tell her that she is fired, and to please wait while we write her another check so she wouldn't have to come back in next week to pick up her last check. While she was waiting, we called the cops who came and arrested her. She took the cop back to her apartment, where she gave them the purse which she had not thrown in the trash after all. She ended up getting deported to Mexico. Simple really. He came to work stoned, spent most of his time spinning a pen lid around in a bottle of water giggling, and ordering in files from our Athens and Bangkok offices, for no reason other than he thought the clients' names were hilarious. Easiest firing I ever did. Used to manage a pizza joint years ago, and another manager hired this gigolo. My first time working a shift with the guy, he was practically sleeping on the counter. I told him he needed to get to work and he blew up. Walking around the store, stomping his feet, taking his shirt off wanting to fight me in front of customers. I'm an ex-bouncer, and I don't take any shit from guys like that, and called his bluff. He ended up leaving, accidentally hitting another delivery driver's car as he sped out of the parking lot. Do I really need to tell you he was fired? Ducking jobs, how do they work? I let myself get pressured by my boss into hiring a copywriter, essentially because she had a huge rack. She did a couple of writing tests that came back okay, and her attributed work on other sites and magazines was passable, so I didn't fight it too much. First day on the job, she announces that she is both dyslexic and suffers from adult attention deficit disorder, and will need all sorts of special equipment to work with, and longer deadlines to complete her work. Not really what you're looking for in a wordsmith. When I pointed that out, she rattled off a list of other companies that she was in the process of suing for unfair dismissal. Happily for me, she also began stalking someone else at work, ultimately sending him hundreds of sexually explicit text messages, so we were able to get rid of her that way. Messages, like, presumably, I want to duck your sock. I didn't actually fire the guy. I didn't get the chance. He starts work at 10 a.m. in the supermarket I manage. At 10:04 I ask him to bring a case of Coke from the storeroom and put it on the shelf. At 10:06 he comes back from the store without the Coke and said, I didn't know this would involve manual labor, and promptly left. 6 minutes total employment time, has to be some kind of record. Similar to your shortest employment ever, although I did get to fire the guy. Used to work retail, and every holiday season we would bring on a bunch of new sales staff to keep up with the crowds. This particular new hire, let's call him Bob, aced the interview, well-dressed, well-informed, affable, etc. And to be honest, when you're hiring seasonal staff you're not looking for the best of the best, just warm bodies to fill space, so Bob was a dream. Bob shows up for his first day at 9 a.m, a full hour before the store opens. Pre-open generally involves a bit of tidying, making change for the registers, etc. As the only manager in the store, I was in charge of the registers. While I'm busy flipping 50s for 20s and 10s, Bob's a few feet away folding shirts. So I drop a roll of pennies and then bend over to pick them up. When I stand back up, Bob's on the other side of the counter stuffing the stack of 50s I had just pulled from the registers into his pocket. He didn't even try to make an excuse, just gave me a whoops look, and silently put the stack back on the counter. Within 5 minutes he had signed his termination papers and was out the door. Total employment time, 10 minutes. I used to run a sports bar a few nights a week. One night when I was off, and the owner was supposed to be there running things, I got a call from one of the bartenders telling me that I needed to come in. When I got there, the owner was sitting in a booth in the back corner, passed out drunk. One of the bartenders was so drunk he was staggering around breaking things. The kitchen staff had walked out, one of the waitresses had burnt herself trying to cook something, and the doorman was apologizing to an irate group of sports fans. Apparently the owner and the drunk bartender had started pounding shots, the owner got drunk and screamed at everybody, the cook and dishwasher walked out with food still on the grill. I sent the drunk bartender home, sent the waitress to the ER, cooked up a bunch of the food that was prepped and sent it out comped, closed the kitchen, camped around for the house, and we ended up having a fun night. Didn't make any money for the owner, but it was fun. After we closed, I took the owner home, and by then he was sober enough to be remorseful. He decided on the spot to hire me as full-time manager, asked me to hire an assistant, and pretty much stayed out of the place from then on. In effect, I fired the owner. We hosted a networking breakfast every other month, and my assistants had to meet me at 6:45 a.m. to set up and check people in. This kid shows up half hour late, sits at the check-in table, and doesn't look at anyone, just crosses his arms and looks pissed. I tell him to check people in and he says, it's too early for this, I don't even want to be here. I tell him, then go home, and he picks up his jacket, walks up to me like he is going to say something slash strike me, huffs and puffs and takes off. I get to the office at 9 a.m, and he's sitting at his desk like nothing happened. I tell him, okay, guy, obviously you are fired, let's pack your things up. He just stared blankly at me and asked quietly, why? I reply, are you goddamn kidding me? Why would I want an assistant who I have to babysit? He replies, yeah, you have a point, and leaves. I like how he just suddenly became rational. Okay, network engineers are going to like this one. Started at this place with an IT department of about 14 people. I was hired to lead the network team consisting of myself and two other guys. One of them was an excellent engineer and one of them was trying very hard, but just didn't have a very logical mind. He also bullcrapped a whole lot about what he knew. Instead of admitting his shortcomings and trying to learn, he donked around relentlessly. And he would always have an excuse to avoid after-hours maintenance. It began to wear on me. Long story short, I learned to deal running on two cylinders instead of three for about 18 months. I sort of got him to a point where he was sort of useful, but we were mostly crippled. Over this course of time I asked my director several times to move the guy to another area. He had a family, and is a very nice guy, but no dice. He was making too much money to move him anywhere else. Letting him go was out of the question. Politics, Long story. Eventually the director leaves, I'm promoted to director heading up the entire department, and I promote my true engineer sidekick to team leader. Backstory, these guys hate each other. Slap guy goes out of his way to piss off competent guy, and competent guy just vents in my office almost every day, like clockwork. Now he's the other guy's boss. Slacker guy just goes limp biscuit at this, and start doing screw all, almost trying to sabotage crap. I had given him 18 months of grace, so now I'm director, I put him on probation after he screws something up. He has 1 month to know his job inside and out, and prove it. One of the tasks I gave him was to document the network, this would demonstrate what he really understood. He doesn't ask competent guy for help, even though he offered it, and donks around for 3 weeks. Eventually he submits it. I look over the documentation and it was worse than I had expected. He had managed to even pull the wool over my eyes to a degree. The basic site domains and subdomains are wrong, and all over the place. Worst of all, the labeled mail server has a completely unrelated domain associated to it. Competent guy and I call him in the next day. We sit down, and I ask him to explain just that page of documentation. It was the first page. He fumbles around, ums and ahs, and finally I ask him, "What's your email address, Ted?" He looks at me quizzically and mumbles and chokes again. I repeat, "What's your email address, Ted?" Knowing he's in a corner, he says, "I know what you're trying to say," to which I reply quite loudly, 20 months of stress, "What's your damned email address, Ted?" He just stares at me. I'm about to repeat myself more loudly when he shrivels and says, ted@derp.com. "That's right, Ted," I respond. "Derp.com. Now, what's wrong with this picture?" The dude still couldn't tell me. I stared at him for a few seconds then said, "Get your things and get out, Ted." As soon as Ted leaves, competent guy loses it and falls on the floor pissing himself. I just let it go that I wasted almost 2 years of salary on this guy, and joined my sidekick rolling. We still ask each other at opportune times, "What's your email address, Ted?"